Welcome back to Cornwall Park for our third installment of today here. It's starting to rain too. We've got our Dean Bell Cup match. Auckland red, Auckland black. Don't worry, jersey colours are not going to be a problem in this one. One is wearing red and one is wearing the same as what the black team wore last. So it's sort of a dark blue, almost black, with a white V on the front. You see the boys being towards the change rooms. There's still a few lingering around, and we see some of our 16s boys and 17s girls still lingering around too, watching the rest of them play. And see our awesome crew here at the stream shop. We see Lewin's head out the window. I'm Dan McKenzie, joined by Lewin Husband. Ready for a good one here, Lewin?
Yeah, I'm excited, mate. We've been spoiled for choice here. It's had some great quality footy. The weather gods have been supporting us. As we just see a little bit of rain trickling down this afternoon, but very impressed with the standard of rugby league, both women's, young women's and young men that's been on display today.
And it has been. It's awesome to see it kicked off with the girls. They really showed it was going to be a tight and thrilling contest. It ended up being a little bit of a blow-up, but we didn't mind that because they were really doing it. We see Auckland Black lined up ready to go in the 16s game. Was a bit the same again, you know, it was a tight contest, almost down to the wire, but then Auckland Black, they just went up a gear, and there's some of our Georgia Hale Cup girls. I think a few of the winners there sitting around, so that's our Auckland White side. It's awesome to see the girls still hanging around supporting the boys too, and I know the boys would have done that. They were here nice and early, some of them watching the girls play beforehand, and still a lot of parents around even with the rain starting to kick in a bit now, which is good to see. You know, it's awesome to see family down there supporting all their children. And the young rangatahi we have playing our game here, as we see, yeah, it's Auckland Red lining up. Look at them, we can see smiles on it. A lot of these boys have played against each other. This Auckland Black lineup is dominated by South Auckland side, the Otara Scorpions, the Leopards, the Bumpies, Hawks, and Manurewa Marlins. Take that up, whereas this Auckland Red side, they're a bit of to and fro amongst the central city area. You know, that was the points that matters. I don't know if they make up, they get the parents and boys, but we see it. Shot there, red Joey Oscar just looking out there. Yeah, no, I think it's going to be a tough one because it's the Auckland Reds lineup again. Likes of Tui Vailopa really doing it well at the fullback spot.
Yep.
Backed up by the halfback Noah Jensen. SG4 player is Noah Jensen. Joey Opoko played in the Akarana side. Really skillful big man. And Tuparoa Winera is again here. An excellent game last time out. Really made the most of everything that came his way in the back row spot, and Auckland Black have a bit of match on. We see up on the hill there the likes of Tuiava Wood at fullback. Again, it'll be a battle of those two today. They're really skillful players. And again, front row Frankie Payne is one to watch. Big barnstorming man. He gets around everywhere. Kalani Peru Donaldson, Augustino Filippo, SD ball player. Great big hand on him. He's not the biggest 13, but he's like the Isaiah Yeo sort of mold. He's sort of a tallish man, but a ball playing skills to match it. So he'll be crucial in getting that sort of extra play out the back for his halves in today. And Auckland Black, coached by Paul Clark of Mount Albert, the other coached by Bevan Thomas of Mount Albert. So it's the Mount Albert affair. I know both of these men personally. Bevan's been around when I've been at the club. Paul used to coach me back in the day. So, you know, dominated by sort of central side coaches in this grade, but it's going to be an enthralling one to go, and as the rain kicks in a bit more, ball security is the way to go, Lewin.
For sure, for sure. I mean, I'm just pleased to see kids or young men out there ripping into the game we love. It's a great segue for them moving into their own junior clubs campaigns for the year ahead. And also, there will be so much opportunity with high schools and first 15 rugby and different player agents out there promising contracts or offers to these kids. So there's some unexpected pressure that sort of comes up into play. So yeah, it's a lot to take on as a young youth.
It is, and we've seen that with the likes of young Mari Timoko, who was a leaguey in his junior years, played rugby at Auckland Grammar, and then poached out by the Raiders, and the Raiders have got themselves a gem at centre there, and they do have a nice little young crop coming through. And we see the first penalty of the day goes to this Auckland Reds side, and it's won by Dante Lolomanaya there. Referee Jackson McGowan quality young ref he is. He lives up in Mangawhai. He's travelled all the way down today, so we got the best of the business coming down.
He has really sort of put his foot down and just stomps out the crap early, and so that's one way how to referee to ensure that these players don't take him for a ride.
Yes, it is, and it'll be important to see what Auckland Red can do here on the set. We see Ollie Horgan, former Akarana player, so he's played a few rep games, SG ball wider squad, Ollie Horgan, he's got a repertoire to his name, along with the likes of Noah Jensen as well at halfback. He's going to be crucial. He's one of the more, I'd say, experienced halves in this grade. You wouldn't put too much experience on them because these boys are only under 18s, but he just carries himself well. His game management is excellent, so I expect them to have a big one here today if they want to get over the line, Auckland Red. Again, Auckland Black, you know, it's falling off tackles here. Not the best start defensively. And when you give Joey Opoko a free license to wind up, look out here. He's been damaging for Maris last year. And in the SG ball, that floats forwards to Ollie Horgan. What's the call going to be? I think that's a try there. Auckland Red draw first blood. Yeah, and Ollie Horgan crosses.
Yeah, a bit of a Harbour Bridge pass over the top there, but all started off with some barnstorming runs from the front rowers of this Auckland Red squad. Good couple of front door dummies.
Ball from Jensen just over the top. He drew in the winger. I'm going to give that one line ball after calling it forwards before. We see a replay here. Yeah, I'll give that line ball. That's not bad. That's a quality pass from Noah Jensen. But even better work from and recognition from Ollie Horgan to stay deep and catch it on the run. You know, that's momentum is a good thing. And just the start Auckland had wanted, but they have to be careful because previous weeks they've gone up big and they've fallen away for a bit of a 15-minute period, you know, and they just do it and it's just gone wide, so it stays 4-0, but again, yep, they've got to be careful, Auckland Red.
The try evolved from that early penalty that they received to make their way up to this end of the paddock. Good option of choice there by Noah Jensen. Points are on the board, Miss Ford, 4-0 in this Dean Bell Cup Grand Final. Obviously Dean Bell, the number one warrior, legend out of the Manukau Magpies.
Yeah, not the greatest one there from Auckland Red, leading the kickoff bounce, almost coughed it up. But and there we go, Auckland Black. Great field position here, and not how Auckland Red wanted to do after scoring points. You know, you always want to complete, and it's just a bit of an unforced error there. I think that was from Samisi Miller there for Auckland Red.
Yeah, nothing worse after scoring a try than and just turning the ball over easily like that. It's like you say, completing the set and getting to the kick is paramount.
Great footwork there from Jeshua Martin Nelson. He was strong last week. They got a last minute winner to win 38 points to 34 last week at Auckland Black. So they do have resilience in them, but it'll just be about maintaining that composure, not working too hard, as we see back at the angle coming through. Francis Tuimonga there. They're firing the play the ball out of a cannon. It's a lot of bodies around the ruck for Auckland Red. So they want to be careful. Spaces out wide. Can they get Tifata and Filo on the ball? There we go, Filippo chiming in. Look at the numbers, weaving, ducking. Ball goes to ground. And that's what Augustino Filippo does. He chimes in nicely, but ooh, almost made something from nothing there. Did Ulugia there. Not the best end to set there. They would have had a repeat set if they could clean it up, but game management and fifth tackle kicking is going to be crucial with this rain, Lewin.
Definitely. You're on the money there, Dan.
Yeah, just tucking the ball in. And even like we mentioned earlier in one of the previous games, it's just going to ground on the first tackle option in these wet conditions rather than giving a seven tackle set or just not completing effectively.
And that's Taipati Wikitera there. He's got a strong carry on him as well. 1 week when they were playing Waikato, gave someone a big don't argue as they go for an early shift down the left-hand side. It's a lot of work. Auckland Black do get there and cover. That's the number 12. That's Bola Lowe. And they go again. Good carry. And it's the wrestle working in there from Filippo. Jensen kicks early in the tackle count, which is an interesting one. The ball's going to sit up well, though, and they've got a bit of work to do to Black. And lovely heads-up play there from Noah Jensen. Good recognition, fullback in the line, and the kick's well-weighted too.
Oh, as they say, a kick is only as good as its chase, and obviously he fed the message to his left-hand edge, which followed through with his kick, and good kick pressure and forced a repeat set.
They take it, and it's given straight off here. Samisi Miller. And he's met with his opposite number, and Francis Tuimonga there. And they do this a lot, Auckland Red. They love to drop men under, try and create that space back around the ruck, but it'll be interesting to see how wide. Oh, they don't need to go wide when you have Joey Orpoko steaming onto it, but they've done well there to stop him. Augustino Filippo in that tackle. Oh, that's not the best pass there from dummy. Half ball finds ground, weaving, ducking. Filippo again in there. That's Darius Niumata there, and the ball hits ground. It's deemed to be not touched. It's a good scramble, though, from Black there. They're able to just navigate it well, and they want to make sure that Noah Jensen doesn't fire another one on the chest as Ollie Horgan has gone back to back. Here, and it's a repeat again. Noah Jensen fires it out of a cannon. 8-0 lead.
Impressive. We saw the over-the-top Harbour Bridge pass in the previous try, and this time we just see the bullet out of the gun. Here we go here. That's classy. And the finish also, we must give credit.
And again, you see all the bodies caught around the ruck. It was a quickish play, the ball, but Noah Jensen. Again, Ollie Horgan's, that's good recognition again. Back-to-back tries. He's nice and deep, hits it at speed, and he's able to weave back in. And 8-0 Auckland Red. And Noah Jensen looks like he'll be taking this kick as our rain. You can see in shot there, it's getting heavier and harder. So for these boys, just the recognition of you've got to play wet weather footy. You're not trying to overplay your hand. Not too many spirals or... But then again, I say that, and they're throwing two cutout balls, and they've scored off it. So what do I know? I'm not the coach. Jensen pushes an easy-ish one to the left. They're only 8-0, though, but if you're Auckland Red, you'll be happy. If you're Auckland Black, not too particularly happy with that defensive set.
Yeah, well, let's hope those two missed conversions don't come back and bite them on the nunu. However, yeah, impressive start by Auckland Red. Two back-to-back tries, 8 points up in the Steam Bell Cup final.
There's our man in shot there before, Ollie Horgan. He's got two tries to his name, and Auckland Black will need a response here. They left it late last week to beat Waikato.
Got to start the set strong. There's difficulty with slowing down these front rowers who get a real roll on.
That was Chris Massina, the fullback, taking that carry there. And again, that's Rico Toyova Ward, SG ball player, looking to really stamp his authority. He needs some early ball. And again, like EJ Mahu Delamere, when he's in space, he's a dream to watch if you're an outside man, outside fan, and that's an error in the play of the ball. And Rob Vakalahi, he was crucial in their previous weeks, and he comes up with an early error there, and Black will be happy with that.
Yeah, a bit of a reliever for Black, who's been on the end of some pretty impressive attack. I'm just get a chance to strut their stuff. Hopefully, they utilize the amount of tackles that they have. Just be mindful of the conditions also.
It's a big shotish there from Taipari Wiki Dehira and Noah Jensen as well in there. A little bit of a push in the play the ball, so lucky to get away with that one was Wiki Tera. But again, like you're saying, using the tackle count, the possible recognition of an early kick in this wet weather, and see if it skids on or not. If it's going to hold up, then you know you chanced your arm and you just keep it safe. But if it's going to keep skidding on, and that's deemed to be stripped out by Auckland Red. Referee Jackson McGowan is a quality young ref. Travelled all the way down from up north in Mangawhai. He ref my game back for Mount Albert, 16-17s in 2016 in the final when we played Howard Hornets. I had the, we got the result, 30 points to 18, but he's a quality ref. I played with his cousin, David Nathan Wong, sister of Tyler Nathan Wong, Blackburn Sevens player, and Blackburn as well herself now. She's jumped in that 15 spot too, and both that pedigree of that family is something to behold. Really good sports family too. As we see again, my man Rico Toyava Ward getting involved for a little early carry in the set. Oh, lovely offload there though, and there we go. That's Peiwu Donaldson. He's a great interchangeable player, can play in the front row, play at 13 and can play back row, so he's got a bit of quality around everywhere. Nice offload too. And Auckland Black on the ascendancy here inside the 20. But you can see the contrast and size difference between the forward packs though, and this red team is massive. And we see another penalty here for a high shot, but which forward pack can really last the distance? That's going to be the question. And it's Peiwu Donaldson again.
Yeah, and also the importance of the bench, you know, sorting that rotation out, especially when you've got big forwards, making sure that you've got your props rotation, and the timing of those substitutions are vital also.
And it's interesting because Black do have an outside back in Maitiasi Lolosio there, who is electric when they bring him on. They brought him on in previous weeks, and he just gives a bit more spark when they go wide on the edges. There's a big dummy and a crash. And we'll see what the call is here. And it's been given a try. They halve the deficit. Auckland Black, they'll be happy with that one, Auckland Black.
Yeah, just a show and go, eh? He found a mismatch. Bigger man up against a smaller man. So when you're close to that line, you're very hard to stop.
Yes, it was Lennox. Tuilolo there. It's an interesting one if he does get it down. It'd be hard to overturn. He's gone straight down on top of the ball. So, I mean, even the video ref in NRL would struggle to overturn that one if it was given a try. But they've halved the deficit of Auckland Black, and they're just back in this game. A little bit of a momentum swinger there.
Yeah, let's see if this guy's brought his kicking boots because his opposition hadn't in their first two attempts. But just what the team and the coach would have wanted in response of this Auckland Black squad, Paul Clark.
See the instruction feedback from the trainer, and he had his boots on last week, did Komavai. He struck them well. Oh, and he's just hooked that one. So it stays 8 points to four. 20 minutes left in this first half. Auckland Red still on top with the two tries to Ollie Horgan. But again, the response is a good one from Auckland Black. Just too big, too strong. Jensen just couldn't hold on there. And the cover from Donce Lolomanaya there, just a little too late there.
Johnny was right on the spot though. He made his call. He was in good positioning, did the referee. And congratulations to the Auckland Black team, breaking the ice for their team.
As that rain just gets ever so heavier now, you can see the brollies out in the back. Trainers just making sure that the boys understand their roles, what's important. And I think again, the bench will be crucial. Auckland Red taking their time, though. Noah Jensen, he's not in a rush. But they want to make sure they stay onside, and discipline's the key here, and they do. We see off the back fence, ready, steady, and it's a bit of a slowdown. He pulled the handbrake on, and it's a lost ball. Wikiteta cleans up.
And I certainly see what you mean, Dan, in terms of contrasting forward packs. You've got one large pack and one sort of more versatile. So we'll see how it pans out towards the end of the game.
And they scoot again, and that's Sams Yeswa. Jensen fires it back to Upoko. Look at him, he's looking for an offload. It's Big Joey. But good work from Jamie Tefata there. But they hit the front door, man. And Kelepi Manukea there. Really trying to barge their way through this middle here as he carries himself to the line there. Samisi Mila was. It's well matched by Auckland Black there, and it's last tackle here. It's gone Jensen back door, and he's looking, he's dummy, he's going. Jensen weaving, he gets a nice little offload there. It's a good try from Auckland Red, a little bit of second phase play. And we see a bit of a rub on the heads of the opposition. It all stemmed from this error off the kickoff. Not how Auckland Black wanted to respond after scoring points.
It did well to hold them out here and reminding ourselves that it was the fifth tackle. Noah Jensen, outstanding. I mean, the first two previous tries he threw two long balls, and then to keep the defense guessing, he'd go to the line himself, nearly go over the line himself and claim the goods. However, having that generosity and feeding the ball back to one of his three quarters and taipari Wikiteta.
It was good work from Jensen again. He's done well to recognize he had the strength to just hold it up and get that offload away. And we see another change of kicker here, and they do this a lot, Auckland Red. They switch between kickers, and again, they haven't converted any of their tries, so it's only an 8-point buffer, which is unfortunate there. They could have made it 18 points to 4, as we see all the umbrellas out now. Everyone trying to duck for some shelter.
Privileged to bring you coverage of the Dean Bell Cup Grand Final here. We've had the Sean Johnson Cup and the Georgia Hale Cup earlier on. If your whānau are around the globe hungry for some grassroots rugby league, then jump on our YouTube channel, the ARL channel, or come and join the game with us, www.playleague.co.nz. We're up with technology here at the Stream Shop and ARL. Grab your phones out, your Nokia 3315, and scan the QR code.
Yeah, scan that QR code as we see a nice rangy kickoff there, and they've let it bounce, and oh boy, do not do that in these wet conditions, boys. Again, we see Posse Money on here for this Auckland Red side. And, you know, I think we see an error there. And Auckland Black, they've done this twice now. Auckland Red have scored. They've coughed the ball up. Auckland Black, vice versa. And just no one really grabbing a foothold in this game here. It's been interesting so far. It's a tight affair.
They'll be stoked with where they're at in terms of the field position. Packing down the scrum 20 metres out.
They feed here Auckland Black, and it's a big run there from Ma'a Nelson. He was strong in their comeback last week, got all the carries going. And again, that's Hirini Holmes off the bench there. He's just come on now. A scoop from dummy half and a response. If that, that's Rico Toyava-Waa going straight from dummy half. Just like in the previous game, Nathaniel Fifita for Auckland Black.
At Cornwall Park, he's been playing some bangers. Some tsunamis have been coming out of his playlist, so he deserves a raspberry lemonade and a pot of chips.
Yes, he does. Shout out to Francis for coming down. He's been down here before with our National Club Challenge for Kiwi Tag DJing, and he's telling us before we started and we were setting up that he's been everywhere. He's been down to the Tron for DJing, out in the Mangere Tavern. He's everywhere on the ground, down in Wellie too, and Dunedin. So he's been a busy man in the past 6 months or so, as Francis. But hey, it was a pleasure to have him down here today playing all the jams we need.
All the whānau as well on their whāriki, on their mats, no doubt with the picnic baskets as well. There's a lot of people that go unnoticed, our nans, our mothers, our parents that take us to trainings and take us to the games, motivate us to do well. So I'd just like to acknowledge all the people behind the scenes.
Again, just Tuiava Ward got nice and Lowe got over it. And again, like you said, we just want to thank everyone. That's a pleasure, because without these boys being able to play in this game, they wouldn't have got down here in our trial matches. All the mums and dads would have dropped them off, would have tried to get off work early, get down here, even the nans and uncles and aunties as well. You know, it's just a pleasure to having all the families down there supporting the boys, even in what's going to be torrential rain in the next hour or two.
100%, and mindful, most of these boys are still at school when they're going through, you know, the challenges of education, the challenges of what employment opportunities might be out there, careers. I mean, I'm still waiting to see what I want to be when I grow up. So there's, a lot of opportunities out there, and so I respect the well-being. Not only the physical well-being of our kids, but the mental well-being as well. And I wish them well for the academic and sporting year ahead.
Yeah, and it's important that the kids at these age, they can get a nice balance between sporting life and schooling life. And even, and more important than that, just having fun outside of both of those, because I know they'll be under pressure to perform in school and on the sports field, but it's just having that nice balance. As we see a nice claim there from Masina, and he's got a little bit of open pasture, but yeah, they just want to find that balance, and that's important for boys this age, because, you know, we haven't emphasized on them really trying to balance it out, as we see a drop ball there, but it's important they don't get hung up too much on putting the pressure on themselves or taking that pressure from parents, just enjoying what they have in front of them, enjoying the footy, enjoying school. A lot of them will be their last years at school, you know, hang out with your mates, do what you want, enjoy yourself. If you go to uni next year, enjoy that.
the Fijian Cup, supporting grassroots Fiji. With international teams flying in to go up against the best club teams in Fiji. Over 50,000 in prizes for each sport, the Fijian Cup is placing a spotlight on untapped talent. A tournament like no other.
Welcome back. Apologies to everyone who is tuning into the Steenbell Cup final. The weather has wreaked havoc. We lost full power, but we're back underway for the second half. The score has not changed since we left you. We loved you, and we're back underway, so we're ready to make it an exciting second half here. 12 points to 10. Auckland Red are up. Converted none of their tries, Lewin, so will that bite them?
Possibly. I'd hate to curse it, but yeah. Possibly. However, the conditions has really wreaked havoc, as you said, on the quality of football. However, you didn't get a chance to see it because we had a little bit of a cup of tea break and a scone. And the score hasn't changed, but we've still got a second half of footy with the difference of just 2 points between these two teams.
And it was an Ollie Horgan cross for the first two of the game before Auckland Black responded. And it was just a simple one there, just an easy miss from Noah Jensen, who couldn't wrap up the try score. And Lennox Tuiolo there. But 12 points to 10 it remains, and it was matched. So they've converted one kick of Auckland Black. Auckland Red have converted none. And you'd say their kicks have been relatively easy, just in front of the post, to the left, to the right. And they've pushed it every time, and it's unfortunate for them. And they would have preferred to have an 18-10 lead, but...
Funnily enough, you guys watching from home, the best goal kicker of the day has been a 50-year-old girl from the Georgia Hale Cup in Braxton Sorensen. And so some of these lads might have to take a leaf out of her book.
Yes, they will. And again, you sit down, come join the game. Go to www.playleague.co.nz or scan the QR code that was just on your screen. Really excited to see the sport grow and go back to what it once was back in the heyday. You know, we're seeing more and more the participation levels have gone up. We've seen an increase in women's footy and women's players across all grades. So that's from the young girls and all the way up to our premier women's grades, up 287%, I think. So it's a wonderful increase to see the amount of women and young girls really getting involved in this game and providing them some more pathways that rugby have always been giving them. So it's awesome to see us competing along that, but also not denying them the opportunity to play rugby, like the likes of Caitlin Vahakolo and co, who like to jump ship every now and then, but we don't mind that. They're doing well representing Black Ferns and the Kiwi Ferns too, so it's all good.
As we see, the Brollies are up. The boys are under the gazebos. However, the whānau is still here. They breed them tough, this rugby league fraternity. We're pleased to have coverage back with Stream Shop. Apologies once again for the little hiccup. The Jenny went down. Today it's the City of Gales. However, we're back providing action of the Steenbell Cup Grand Final. Auckland Red up against Auckland Black. And they don't have any direct relationship to pockets of New Zealand. It's just confirming the score, it's 12 points to 10 with Auckland Red. In the break, Auckland Black had a foot on touch and they missed an awesome opportunity down the right-hand edge.
And while we were off as well, it seemed like there was a bit of drop ball creeping in from both sides. I think weather's playing a big handle in that as Jamie Tefata goes down the left-hand side and a little half break, and I think it's going to be all but short passes now. You won't see those two cutouts from Noah Jensen to score Red's first two tries. And you see bobbles sliding out everywhere as well around with these boys.
Really like that defense of Larakai. Pusimani rushed up and made his tackle with intention.
You know, with the boys these age, testosterone's flying around. It's going to get a little bit chirpy from them every now and then. Across the grounds, and we see Massina taking that run, and Ollie Horgan, not the best start. He started with a hiss and a roar, scoring two, and That one has been left in the back fence, and Auckland Black ascendancy here, early ball, good position.
Yeah, just too handy, eh? Just sitting on the back fence, getting a decent run up, and in these conditions, you just gotta, yeah, make sure you tuck the ball under and tuck it under the wing and go hard.
Referee Jackson McGowan calls time off. As you can see, the boys in the front row chirping along. So I think it's all fun and games until someone's gonna get the last laugh. And we've seen a few sledges coming everyone's way, so it'll be interesting to see how these boys roll it off. As again, that's Matiasi Lorosio there coming off the bench. And he's lost the ball, so Auckland Red, they breathe a sigh of relief. Auckland Black, nice field position, but just an unforced error there in the wet conditions.
Yeah, I hate to say it, but you know, you could almost get a feel that something like that was coming, and unfortunately these conditions look like they're not going to change for the next 32 minutes.
No, they won't, but you know what won't change? The intensity of both these boys really trying to get a win here. No converted tries for Auckland Red. Noah Jensen scheming. He throws a dummy to Jensen, and he's almost through there.
Tough carry. Bumped off the first one and gained his team a penalty. Rico Toyava Ward. Excuse me, and Dylan Tuatangaloa.
We see a little bit of a slip there, almost could have ended badly with a bit of a knee injury. Jensen drops one under. Tuatangaloa there for Auckland Red. And just for viewers at home, you'll be happy that someone's not wearing a blue coloured jersey, or one team's wearing a blue coloured jersey and the other's got red on. It's a lot of one out though to start this half, and again it's ball security lacking for both sides.
Huge tackle, big shot put on by Kalani Peru. Donaldson, he let him know too.
And then penalty one again by Francis Tuimonga there. He's done well to get him for some dirty work as Francis. And Augustino Filippo wearing the number 21 playing in the back of the scrum. Apologies, that's Rico Toyava Ward wearing the 21. Augustino Filippo with 20 on his back. Offside penalty there, so a bit of a pressure reliever there. And back and forth, no one really having that ball security to start the second half for both sides. And it'll be interesting to see who can hold this ball, really work the screws in such horrible conditions after we had a nice start with the girls. It rained quite early in the morning before we kicked off, but then the weather dried out, sun came out for what was half an hour as we see a little break. They got four on the tackle there to Auckland Red. It was quite slow off the ruck there. And they go again. That's Hezony Holmes. He's come off the bench, made a bit of an impact. It's Jamie Tefata now. Oh, breaking through 1-2. Oh, and a big spinning tackle. We got a bit of a head injury, it looks like, there for one of the Auckland Red players. And Filippo hits a hole. Straight through his man was there, Lennox Drulo. Fullback chiming, Enrico Tuiava Ward. Look at him looking for an offload. Oh, the temptation, ever so close. And he would have given his side given away a penalty for his side with a double movement there, but he's done well to just maintain it. We'll see who's down his back player.
Yeah, just mindful at the moment of player welfare. And obviously, one of the young men took a head knock, and we know the likes of Tamaide Martin and the history that he's had with concussion and possible aneurysms, and so I'm respectful of the delay of game here.
Yeah, James Tedesco suffered a bad one on Thursday night too, and it's not looking good out there. I think that might be Darius Numata there.
I was impressed with how he chopped down that strong ball carrier. It looked like a Brazilian jiu-jitsu leg sort of trip. But he come off second best. Might have caught a boot or something to run blood from the nose.
Yeah, so they'll send him to the blood bin as Wikitera gets us back underway and almost driven back into the end goal. Strong defence there from Auckland Black, and it's what you like to see. And Auckland Red doing all the hard work, and there's our man with two tries to his name, Ollie Horgan, after two wonderful cutter passes from Noah Jensen. And they'll need a bit of help from the outside backs here. Well, Auckland Red really rolling their sleeves up as we see a back fence carry and a bump and a weave. That's Isaiah Fale. As we see a 40-20 attempt here, not a bad kick, but it finds... That's Matiasi Lolosio there taking that run, coming off the bench wearing the number 3. And again, Black, that's second tackle on the halfway line here, so they'll be happy if they can get a result here. And that's Malama Talataina there, hasn't had too much to do. A lot of defensive work, but he gets an offload away. That's Lolosio there. Just direction around the park now is going to be crucial for the likes of Jamie Tefata and Atelea Filo for their side, and along with Noah Jensen, Darius Numata as well. And it'll be interesting to see if Darius carries on with this injury he suffered. As Tuiava Ward chiming in. But game management's crucial. Conditions like this, you want to try and find touch and give your side a bit of a breather, not really overdoing it. But they go down the blind side, and it's good. Hands here, denied off camera. Was Komarvai, and he responds, and he got a bit of a sledge too in the first half, and he's dished one back out. So it's tit for tat, and Auckland Black take the lead now.
Yeah, it's all start from strong carries like this. I've been impressed with the efforts of the front rower. Does well our winger in Colwyn Saya Komarvai to not only get the try, however, cut back on the inside and make the kick a little bit more easier with the difficulty it already has. Smart heads up play here, stacking the short side. Good initiative from our dummy half here, identifying that there could be a simple draw and pass on the right hand edge. Well deserved try for Auckland Black.
Yes, it was, and they rolled down with that set with a little bit of ease. So if you're Auckland Red, you won't be too happy with that. You know, you gave away a bit of a piggyback and then carried on with a good couple of carries, but the short side recognition, that shouldn't be happening. They should have numbered up well. You can see one marker going back with his back turn to play. Not the best way to do it. You really want to sort of be side on so you know what's going. And I think if he was side on, they would have slid to that side, numbered up 3-on-2. You defend it well, but...
Well, no wonder why he was trying to bring his try around, because he's the goal kicker. So...
Making it easier for himself.
Yeah,
there.
That's right.
Again, we see the Black, Auckland Black in the huddle there. Tuiava Ward and Co, that's on shot. Komarvai there taking this kick. He struck one well nicely from the sideline in that first half before we lost coverage. We'll be lining this one up again. It's not a bad strike. He's got a bit of hook on it too, and it's a lovely kick that is. Extends the lead to a 4-point buffer, and that's crucial. That's 2 from 3 they've made, Auckland Black.
Another look at the replay here. Simple draw and pass down on the short side. Good efforts from from Kalani Peru Donaldson. That right-hand edge, Coach Paul Clark will be stoked with that display. It's been a tit-for-tat game. Dan?
Yes, it has. It's been back and forth, as you say. You know, Auckland Red, they started with a Hisanaroa 8-point lead. Auckland Black responded. Then Auckland Red took again another 8-point lead, but two back-to-back tries now from Auckland Black, one either side of the half. And it's not a bad little kickoff, but they've got a 4-point buffer, and they've made two of their conversions, so that might be crucial in this wet weather footy here.
It's a privilege to celebrate this awesome game with us alongside our Pacifica Māori, and even our non-Polynesian brothers that may be playing. That culture language is very important. There's a movie out at the moment that I encourage you to all watch called Red, White and Brass, which celebrates how passionate our Tongan whānau are about their not only their sporting accolades, but their religion. And yeah, it's a great watch. You'll thoroughly enjoy it.
As we see Black go deep there, and it's 2 Ward with a bit of a backspinning midfield bomb, and it's coughed up. Lucky not to be penalised for that, because it was deliberately played out from Auckland Red after the knock-on, so they'll breathe a sigh of relief with just only receiving a scrum here, but that one went up, 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 and you could see Horgan and Messina both wanting it, and neither came down with it at the end. And Tuiava Ward, just a classic midfield bomb it was.
I like the intention of Manase Lokotui. He was never catching that ball. His goal was just to get up and put the opposing fullback off, and that's what he did.
And you don't see too many contests even in the NRL nowadays off kicks. It's a lot of just stand back, watch them catch it, but we can see a good chase there from Lokotui. He's done well to get the ball back for his side. As we see Cameron Tuipulotu on the field now at dummy half. Played his brother last week, and that would have been a fun one as Peru Donaldson leaves one in his weight. He's still going as Kalani Peru Donaldson. Again, they drop it in, Hirani Holmes. We've got a little bit of a forward pass going there, and not the best response from Auckland Black Prime. Field position too, and
it was unnecessary. I mean, he didn't have to turn that ball. He already had a runner on his right-hand edge. I don't know what Jamie Tefata was thinking there. He must have got a late call from one of his mates saying, hook me up, and turned it back on the inside, and it went forward.
And it's just the recognition that these young guys will learn when they keep playing, they keep growing and evolving their craft of playing. And so the likes of Tefata in 5 years, he probably won't throw that pass. He's thrown it now, but he'll understand that when you know you've got your runner already past you, you might as well just play what you see on the other side or just throw the dummy and go. And it's a great learning experience as well for these guys playing against, again, their own age boys, different sizes, different background. As Horgan, bit of space. He's coming back in field though. And again, they go again. Offload bearing, but Sanji Sua takes that run there. Bit of that David Clemmer shake going on the ground there.
Look a bit shell-shocked, the Auckland Red team, from the domination of Auckland Black.
Tuiava Ward cleans up that kick from Jensen. Not enough height on it, you'd say, from Jensen. I think he might have wanted that to go a bit further in the sky and do well. Apologies, that wasn't Tuiava Ward. That was our main man, Matiasi Lolosil, there claiming that kick. But again, you've got to watch out for Big Joey Opoku. He's going to put you on a bloody poster in a minute. The way he's going to bounce around. Look at him in there. Joey Opoku frees that ball up.
They have a big hug after it. Contact on the ball in these conditions, it's, yeah. As we see once again, good way to get out of a marker and got some good contact on the ball.
Oh, big head rock there. You can see the water bounce off the throw. And that's Joey Opoku for you. Really going to get stuck in. He plays big minutes, so look to see if Auckland Black can utilize their ball and hold on to it. They will tire him out. As Jensen slides one on the back door, and it's a half chance there. Well grabbed by Tuiava Ward, though. And Jensen, oh, the big dummy, almost from dummy half there. Wikitero will find himself in at the 9 roll. Bouncing off that again, that's Tuatangaloa there. Here we go, look at Joey Opoku finding the front rower. Samisi Mila there. And just as I say that, Samisi Mila coughs the ball up. Auckland Black breathe a sigh of relief there.
Yeah, it's pleasing to see our front rowers having with ball playing prowess. And so prop to prop. Just a bit of a bubble when he tried to get to his feet and play the ball, I think. Game management now.
Yes, it is. You know, less than 20 minutes. It's still pouring down heavily, and I think if you're a kicker, you'll want to see that ball go as far in the air as possible, really put the back three under pressure. Otherwise, you just do nice, crisp, short passes off the ruck, nothing too fancy or expensive, and a little love tap on the back of the head there from Rob Vakalahi. And again, good little run. Malawa Talataina there with a little pressure-relieving run. And a penalty too. Good work from the young man playing in the centres today with the fullback jersey on.
Yeah, just what the doctor ordered, that one.
And a lot of these boys in this Auckland black side, Otara Scorpions, Otahu Leopards, a couple from Mangere East, even one from Point Shed Pirates. That's our man who got that penalty, Malama Talataina there. You know, it's awesome to see these boys, if they don't crack it into the Warriors SG ball, we'll still see them in Fox showcasing their talents. And after that, New South Wales Cup ball bearing, you can be like the likes of Aiden Ackley, you know, play Fox for a few, many years. You're in the 20 system for the Warriors, but then you're back into Fox, you're back from Fox again into New South Wales Cup. And just, I think, those stepping stones there, it's a lot of learnings as well, which these boys will cherish down the road. And there's Frankie Payne, hasn't had too many runs today. He's been barnstorming in the previous weeks, and a bit of a limp going on there as Tefata finds hands and almost for Hidani Holmes there. That's Lolosio, fires it down the left-hand side. Oh, big hit there from Masina, or Wikitira it was. The scoot and ever so short. Po Viviani there. That's a touch and go one there, and Auckland Reds celebrate that.
Hang on, they're going up and having the arm with his touchy. I thought there were hands in the ruck here.
That one's a bit of touch and go for me because the ball has cleared the ruck, but then he isn't coming from a square position, so.
What about Sean Johnson's rake? And what about Kikau's rake? I mean, it's a touchy subject at the moment, raking the pill.
Yes, it is, and you never know what the call's going to be each week. One referee adjudicates it this way, the other says this way, and they do have the penalty, though, so they benefit from it. It was deemed to be knocked out, and a man not square at marker there. So I think that's a little bit of a lucky break for Auckland Black. I mean, it could have gone either way, but they'll try and make the most of it here and extend that lead.
Here we go again. You can see the example of why the penalty was given.
Yes, so he isn't on his feet, which constitutes an offside player. That's why, and playing at the ball like that, you will be penalised. So that's a good call from the touchy there. Good spot. So I think the ruling is you have to have both knees off the ground to be deemed a live player, as we see a little bit of a man caught in the ruck and a flat ball for Payne that was borderline forward and an error too, and Auckland Black are not going to be happy with that. Auckland Red will cherish that.
I think he's playing with a bit of a niggle, our front rower here, Mr. Payne. Certainly some pain in his left YY.
Just dropped a cold straight out of the bread basket. But if you're Auckland Black, you don't mind that though. 10 metres out, you're turning the ball over there. It's not a bad position. It'd be important for them to really aim up defensively because they've had Auckland Red pinned down in their own end for the last 5 minutes or so. So just maintaining that pressure, aiming up defensively will be key here. But if you're Auckland Red, you really want to back for a piggyback, as we see a bit of a seatbelt tackle there over the top on Wikitera. And that's the big fella, Dante Lolomanaya. They're taking that run. He's got the nice rat's tail with a bit of a mullet going on. And again, these shots from Auckland Black are firing out left, right, center. That's Posse Money with that run. Jensen goes early, and it's not a bad kick. He's found grass, so it's a bit of a pressure reliever there. Look at the chase from Horgan, though. Again, that's Lolosio there at fullback. So it's interesting to see where Rikotoiava Ward has been placed now. He may be on that right-hand wing. We won't know until we find out. So Komaivai might be off the field, which will be interesting to see how Toiava Ward injects himself on the wing.
I was impressed with that kick there that found the grass, as you said, and the defenders.
That was a beautiful ball. There's Toiava Ward. That's the Gordon Tallis treatment with a bit of a flop afterwards. Oh, that's an interesting one there. That looked like he had a bit of momentum.
I mean, when is the tackle completed? You know what I mean? Once the momentum stops.
And again, it's another touch and go one. You could argue the claim if you're Auckland Black that the tackle was made. I think he just stops just there, but then Wikitetta rolls and spins and the elbows out, and Horgan with a bit of afters over the top. He loves dropping in those, Ollie Horgan. He's done that in previous weeks. Really fires up defensively. But again, that early kick from Noah Jensen, I think that was a bit of a pressure reliever. The chase on that left-hand side didn't back up the quality of the kick, but it'll be important for Auckland Red to just maintain that composure there.
We've got a game on our hands, Dan. It's anyone's for the taking. There's, you know, just over 10 minutes and only 4 points the difference. Momentum seems like it's shifted to the Red squad.
It will, and there's Joey Opoku, a bit of a plumber's crack going there. But he's still going. It's Joey. He'll keep running and running and running. Oh, and a good shot there. Number 20. That's Augustino Filippo. It's weaving around. That's Paula Lau. It's a scoot there from Sams Yesua. And the game management from these boys is just lacking at that stage. That's where you want Noah Jensen or Darius Numata in the halves to really say, boys, give me the ball. We're going to try and just put a kick in. But again, Joey Opoku, he's tough to handle as Big Joey.
Yeah, you shouldn't be making these mistakes, getting caught out on the last. And especially as a vital role as the hooker.
Got to work around the top there from Lolo Manaya, really trying to put the pressure on. Outside backs are important here. And again, another carry for Matiasi Lolosil there. And they've done well now, Auckland Red, just to slow the ruck speed down. Auckland back aren't getting too much of a roll on. We see a big shot there, and good work defensively from Manukia. So it's good defensive step there from Auckland Red. That shot, they spun it wide at Auckland Black. And
I mean, what was he trying to achieve there? I don't know why I would throw the face ball to the winger in that sort of space of the field. But no discredit to the defense. It was an impressive tackle.
And again, that's that game management there. Just understanding where you are running out of room, wet conditions. You're always going to be sliding across the turf. And again, it's vital field position there for Auckland Red. Can they capitalize, though? That's the question. As we see Jensen get absolutely rocked in half by Ma'a Nelson. They go again. It's a face ball. Horgan's hands let him down.
It was on. It was on. Had some good depth, but yeah. The ball was on his chest.
You could see that space in front of him, Ollie Horgan. I think he wanted to keep running onto that. As I think that was Taipari Wikitera there at first receiver. And interesting to see where he's chiming in, if he's playing in that centre role, or if he's jumped in the halves now with Darius Numata off the field. And you can see the boys still talking in the scrum. Yeah, he's really put his hand up as Lulusil, getting involved off the bench. Now playing in the fullback role with two other wards sliding out into that right-hand side. It's Filippo. Goes again. backed up by the front rowing Tuimonga there. Nice and direct from Auckland Black on the seat. You know, they're heading back up the middle, really getting some space behind the ruck. And as I say that, I've just pulled the commentator's curse again for the fifth time in about 5 weeks down here.
It's part of the gig, Dan. Don't kick yourself too much. The rain's eased up a little bit out here at Cornwall Park. However, the pitch is still very wet. The team that can complete their sets and hold on to this ball will be victors. It's tough in these conditions, though.
It is, and we've only seen one try in the second half as well, and that's gone to Auckland Black, which they've converted, and with the rig is out. Ladies and gentlemen, the shirt is off, the rig is out. Be careful there. Oh, and we see another head-rocking tackle there. That's the 14 in Auburn, London there. And he's playing it off the mark. But again, like you said, Lewin, whoever completes is going to go on to be the victor here. And we've got a one-try second half, but it's been locked with errors either side and a half break, and it's still a break. And weaving, ducking as bowler Luau there. And Jensen, the floater to Horgan, backing himself for the hat trick. Did he get the ball down? That's the question there. And a spray. He does get it down, Ollie Horgan, for the hat trick. Locked up 16 apiece. Kick to come, though, and this kick is going to be a crucial one.
Did he get it down? That's the question. Well, it's too late now. It's on the newspaper. It's already been given. We're spoiled because we're actually bringing the pictures to you. We've got a locked up score. How cool. How good.
And again, I'll just reiterate this in the instance of a locked score at full time. It is 10 minutes one way. And then after that, you get an extra 10 minutes and then it's golden point. So extra time with the first 10 minutes. You can just score as many points as you like. After that, it's golden points. So the field goals will be coming out sooner or later.
Well, it's up to Noah Jensen if we're going into extra time or not with this kick.
This is a big kick from the sideline there. And Ollie Horgan, he gets the handshakes all around for his hat trick. But the game's not done yet. SG ball boy. And Noah Jensen getting instructions from the water boy. Just straight down the sticks, Noah. That's all you need, mate. And he's pushed it to the right. Noah Jensen didn't have the legs either. So we're locked up 16 apiece. Less than 6 minutes left in the second half. Only two tries in this half. An error riddle just because of the conditions. But other than that, we've had a close and thralling game. Does Ollie Horgan get the ball down? I think he just gets it down there before those legs spin into touch.
Yeah, he's finished things off really well, has Ollie Horgan. He's got a bit of a reel coming up in the highlights package of three of his tries. Coming down to an awesome last 5 minutes of the Dean Bell Cup Grand Final.
Black get us back underway here, and they want to make sure Auckland Red, that is, to complete the set as we see the ball bouncing off the kickoff and legs chopped out by Peru Donaldson there.
I wonder if any of the halves have a drop kick in their arsenal.
Yep, they want to make sure they make those meters first before we get to that, or even a 40-20 as Jensen slides one, but he's eaten alive there by Ma'a Nelson again. He's put shots on. And it looks like Komave's back on the field. It'll be interesting to see where he's playing. Oh, as we see a big, don't argue there, Lulu Menaya. And they're going again, Opoko. They need to know it's the last. Well, that's fourth there. This one might be last. I think they're setting up. They're going to kick for the last, a flat one. Oh, well picked up there from Kumavai. That's a tough one to take. Getting along the turf, wet one as well.
Yeah, good little stabbing kick there to finish off that set as we see another little look at it. A low sort of punt driven with force. Tied it up well there from the back three.
And there we go. We wanted it. They'll want the forwards to get a bit of a roll on here. Auckland Black really get out of there as we see no markers. Easy meters back up the middle, and there we go. Just like that, Malamatalataina. Bit of a flop on that one, not penalised by referee McGowan. Filippo finds Peru Donaldson, who's really trying to spin it early, and they've got a bit of wheels. He needs to stay in, though, and whoa, he's just got the offload away. Good quick play the ball from Peru Donaldson. Tefota, here we go, midfield bomb, it's up, it's spiralling, it's going to be claimed, it's knocked on, and it's claimed there for Auckland Black. Well, Worker, who scored that try for you there? They like that one.
Jamie Tefota Senior in there with a big smile for his son's spiral bomb.
And he was down last week as well, watching his boy playing, his boy had an awesome game, and just watch it again, he gets under that belly of the ball. Looking it up, Horgan at fullback in this one, and just a bit of a collision.
Dream result for the Auckland Black squad. Knew with the conditions that any type of ball that gets height like that will be difficult to take, and fought it up by a great chase, put kick pressure on.
And it was Kelepi Manukia running back, trying to claim it over his shoulder, and that's a tough one to do in wet conditions like that. I think he could have just left it for Ollie Horgan to attack there, and there's Coach Paul Clark on screen. He's had a tough time with these boys. You know, he's the coach, manager, trainer. He's doing all the gig here. Former coach of mine back when I was playing 13s, 14s and 12s, 13s. Really good coach. Coached the likes of both Nathan Cleary and Aidan Acklin back in his heyday. Coached Akarana as well, and he'll be pleased with his side there. They really got into the dogfight.
The beard's pretty pleasing too there, Dan.
Oh, he's had that beard since I've been about 12, so I don't think it's changed ever so slightly.
A couple of greys in there probably from all his coaching. Big mihi to Paul.
As we see, that's an important kick too, and it's a nice strike, and it's up and over. That's a big kick there. So that's a six-point buffer now. That was Cameron Tuipulotu with a conversion.
Matty Burton bomb, mate. That's what it come down to from Jamie Jr. Tefota. Boom, copped the shoulder too, did Ollie Horgan.
And I don't clarify me on this team, but I'm pretty sure that was Antonio Ulugia who claimed that one there. It looked like he was the number five in there, along with Augustino Filippo, who got into that. But it's good recognition from the winger to come in on the last, you know, put pressure on the kick, and they're happy here. Oh, the Auckland Black side, not much time left in the second half. Short kickoffs to go now.
Yeah, we're finding touch. Nope.
And they go long, and an interesting play as the hooter sounds, and they just got to take the tackle to Auckland Black. And the hooter goes, the kick from Jamie Tefota. Got a result at the end of it. Clutch play for Auckland Black, and they win 22 points to 16 in this under-18s Dean Bell Cup match. And boy, what a game it was, Lewin.
100% halftime, it was 12 points to 10. We come back, I was so proud that Stream Shop regathered and regrouped to celebrate. What an awesome second half that was.
It was an excellent second half. A real tight affair, and this is the crucial play from Jamie Tefota. Put it right up, and you can see the chase. Look at them in there. Olugea, Filippo and co. Look at that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 around the ball. And it was a tough take, but Auckland Black will be happy with that.
You can just see the joy in some of these players' faces. We're going to throw to a break and we'll come back for the presentation. Congratulations once again to Auckland Black and for you guys watching and listening from home. We'll be back soon.
The Stream Shop are experts in live video content creation, connecting communities by sharing the magic moments as they happen. All sorts of sports delivered on any platform, to anyone, anywhere in the world. We deliver cost-effective, high-quality production that really changes the game. It's the next best thing to being there live. Shoot it, stream it, share it with the Stream Shop, proud supporters of the ARL.
The Fijian Cup, supporting grassroots Fiji. With international teams flying in to go up against the best club teams in Fiji. Over 50,000 in prizes for each sport, the Fijian Cup is placing a spotlight on untapped talent. A tournament like no other. The Fijian Cup, supporting grassroots Fiji. With international teams flying in to go up against the best club teams in Fiji. Over 50,000 in prizes for each sport, the Fijian Cup is placing a spotlight on untapped talent. A tournament like no other.
Welcome back for our presentation and an absolute thriller between Auckland Black and Auckland Red. 22 points to 16. And it was all down to that spiral bomb at the end for Jamie Tefuta, who put it up and away. And they got a result off, and that four-pointer was the difference there.
Yeah, here we have a look at it. Great spiraling bomb. Kickers is only as good as its chase. And look at all the numbers that we're hoping for. A result and a dream result eventuated. We'll listen and throw to Rochelle and the ARL staff that have been celebrating the achievements from the Georgia Hale Women's Under 15s division and the Sean Johnson Cup. And finally here at the Dean Bell finals. Come and join the game, Ehua Ma. Playleague.co.nz. Scan this QR code right now and you'll get all the information that's needed for you to connect your whānau, your tamaiti, your children to their local clubs, to help them become better people, make friendships, lifelong friendships, I might add. And that's what rugby league does best.
Pardon?
Refereed really well this afternoon. Rugby league is in great health here in Tamaki Makaurau.
Good afternoon. Salo falanga manuelei, pakalo falahi atu. Kia ora e kia ora ana
Whakapono Katoa. On behalf of Auckland Rugby League, we'd like to acknowledge both teams for a great display of footy. You should be very proud. Your family and your friends are very proud of you too. So well done, boys. Before we start the formalities, we have a few acknowledgements we want to thank. Firstly, you can't have a game without a referee, so if we can get a round of applause for your finals referees. Thank you for your services and very best of luck for the rest of the season. Thank you, boys. Moving forward to the One New Zealand Warriors for their continuous support throughout the past 2 years. New Zealand Rugby League for sanctioning this event and also providing us with the equipment. To my colleagues at Auckland Rugby League for tirelessly making sure that everyone was good. And also, we want to acknowledge your coaches, your managers and your staff for making sure that you guys were looked after. So if we can give them a round of applause for having that. Alright, so moving on to our presentation. So the first award today will be the Most Valuable Player. And your most valuable player today is Kalani Peiro. Kalani, well done. Congratulations.
Firstly, I'd just like to say thank you and glory and praise to the man above you. Without him, this wouldn't have been possible. I'd like to say thank you to all the supporters, community, all our coaching staff, leadership crew.
I will invite the runners up captain to say a few words if he wishes.
No doubt these boys would have played against each other through the grades.
It's interesting to see when it comes to red stuff. You know, there's the added bit of fuel where they really want to get one over them, take it back to club lane and get the last laugh, and that's what I love to see.
To the boys in black, hard fought game. Thank you. To my coaching staff, a bit like wobbly, but we made it. The truth's not there, but we made it. To my boys, we came in as the underdogs. Thank you.
So I can invite your team up to receive the medals, please.
She speaks really well, does Michelle Tamarua. She's not really talented on the field, but the whistle, she's not bad with the microphone as well.
In the background shot there, Vigo Rasmussen, referee as well, my boss in the football development department. He's come back from our AGM at the office and he's made his way down here for the final presentation. It's good to see him down here. He's reffed a few of the games for both these sides and for the 16s as well, and it's awesome to see that he's down here really supporting the boys. And he's another one of the number one supporters of this pathway for these boys, you know, really offering that opportunity for them to showcase their talents too, as well having it on the live stream, so we've got all around the world. I know my relatives in Aussie have been watching it. They watch it to listen to my commentary, but I prefer them to watch it for the footy, because I know they're stacked for talent over there in Australia and Sydney especially, and it's awesome to see them tuning in here to watch what New Zealand has to offer too. So really seeing some young and upcoming players to really showcase their talents, which is amazing to see. And I've heard we've also been around the world as well. Even in Europe, there's a few people that have spotted it up over there. I remember one guy I was talking to from Mount Albert, his wife was watching all the way over in Saudi Arabia, I'm pretty sure he said. It was our first or second try that day for Ollie Horgan.
He got three of them. The last one was the last roll of the dice, however, we all know how it ended with Jamie Tevata's spiral bomb caused havoc. Here's Jamie Tevata Senior.
Alright, so now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the grand final winners of the 2023 Dean Bell Auckland Black. Let's move to, if we can invite the captain, say a few words, follow that. We'll have your team come up and receive their medallions. Thank you.
It's Alan Malabar Taratana there coming up to say a few words for us.
As much as he screams the last day of training, we still get it done. Thanks to him for being here today. Thank you, Paul. And to the other boys, hard luck. You guys give it all your best. And just give it over to the group. Everything was already said. Thank you to the Lord again. And you all have a good day.
Kalani Peru Donaldson, outstanding game defensively and offensively, made some master runs on that left hand side. The boys a little overzealous there, they need to get a rest of the team.
That's your final, grand final winners, the Auckland Black team. Well done, boys. Again, on behalf of Auckland Rugby League, thank you to everyone for coming out. We wish you the very best for the rest of the season. See you later.
The privilege of calling three games for you, Daniel McKenzie. I thoroughly enjoyed it. It's nice to see and be exposed to the youth and the talent that we have, which still strongly exists here in NZ.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure calling with you too, Lou, and look to see you during the regular season as well, and for the Fox qualifiers coming up soon, so they're in a couple of weeks, so keep an eye out down there. We've got a few down at Fouts Park and Code. Walker Park for Point Shev, you know, they're really looking to get amongst it, but it's been a pleasure watching these boys today. And signing off from myself, Lewin, and the Stream Shop crew, we'll be back down there shortly for you guys in the coming weeks. So enjoy the rest of your weekend. Take care, stay dry.